So, I played the Chronicles of Riddick, Assault of Dark Athena, on the PC. It was a big fucking mistake, I think, because it was fucking bugs everywhere. But anyway, I had this feeling that a lot of people really liked this game and thought it was amazing, one of the best games from, I don't know, last gen. But I think it's just my imaginations, because I thought at least Assault on Dark Athena was pretty fucking horrible. So far, I only played Dark Athena, and I'm just, you know, doing the review now because I don't want to forget anything. I mean, it's still the same box, but well, I gotta review those two together. So yeah, I thought it was pretty fucking horrible. So I just felt like I was doing something wrong because a lot of people fucking liked it, but I looked at some reviews of the beta game and didn't really feel like anybody really thought the game was amazing, so I guess it was just my fucking imagination. But anyway, let's get down to it. The gameplay then. Well, it has a lot of variety. Too bad it kind of stops in the middle. I mean, in the beginning you can, you know, do stealth or you can go guns blazing, but sooner or later the game just said, "No, it's time to shoot." I mean, like a lot of other reviews says, it's the gameplay is kind of schizophrenic. It never really makes up its mind if it wants to, you know, sneak or it wants to shoot or it wants to do what the fuck. So it's not really that good. And you have the option, at least on some enemies, that you can go with hand-to-hand combat. And I don't really know. I think I did something wrong because I say it's fucking broken because it isn't really anything special about it. You just hit them until you get an animation that, you know, kills them. I mean, they say, you know, you can swing left and right and up and down, but it doesn't really feel like it has a lot of. It doesn't really feel like it changes anything. I mean, it doesn't feel like it does more damage or anything. I mean, and you can always like counterattack, but it's like, well, I don't fucking get it. I mean, they should have explained it better, I'd say. Oh. And it also has this moment that it looks like it's the end, but it's not the end, and they just, you know, they extend it fucking like 2 hours in a fucking planet, and well, it felt a lot like Rage. My head turned into fucking yellow because it was so fucking boring. Okay, then, but the story then, well, it's pretty fucking horrible too. Well, let's touch with the characters. Okay, it's a lot of characters there, but it doesn't really lead to anything because they all just die. I mean, okay, they don't really build up them either, and don't really make anything special when they die. They just, you know, die. So you shouldn't really bitch about it because they never really fucking try to build up anything. But it just felt like a waste of fucking time speaking to somebody when they're just fucking dead. I mean, dying later. And then we got Riddick. The only thing he fucking does is say something goddamn fucking obvious all the fucking time. And it also felt like they were trying to make it, well, how should I say it, dark and edgy for no apparent reason whatsoever fucking ever. Fuck. I mean, they kinda show out, "Oh, look at this little child, it's so, her mommy died, and oh, they're making zombies, oh no, they're so evil," but well, they don't have the authorizations to do it because the story is not that fucking deep. I mean, the characters are fucking dead. I mean, it's not that it fucking doesn't lead to fucking anything. Why do they even fucking try to make it special? They just make it worse when they're trying so fucking hard. They can just try to make it fucking hilarious. No, we need to make it serious. It's so fucking dumb. But okay then. So after I like. After you land on a fucking planet and do the same fucking thing of 2 hours just in a fucking planet. And I told, well, my head turned into yellow because it was the same fucking shit and it was just so fucking boring. I thought it was fucking horrible, but then, you know, something happened. Well, yeah, it's not. Well, I'm gonna spoil it because it's not that good of a game. What happens is that they make, you know, like robots out of dead bodies, like zombies or something. And what they do is that they like hack in, and the little girl hack into them, to them, and then they start killing the I don't know, mercenaries. But they don't say it's mercenaries. Ah, fuck it. I don't fucking give a shit. And then, you know, Reddick says something goddamn obvious. That isn't so fucking obvious. It was something you would not, something like the slave always turned to the master. I know it doesn't fucking mean anything, to be honest, but it did change a bit. It changed from horrible to just bad. And then also the fucking story. What the fuck was going on, to be honest? What the fuck was the big objective of the game? What was the goal, to be honest? What is just, you know, a coincidence that he was on the fucking spacecraft, and then that just came out of fucking nowhere, took them in, and oh look, that's her, I know her. But the player don't fucking know unless you were supposed to play Butcher Bay first. And well, I thought that was a fucking deal, I need to play Butcher Bay first, but they didn't show any fucking indication that you needed to play Butcher Bay because the game fucking was Dark Athena, it wasn't play Butcher Bay. True. Fuck. But anyway, they don't fucking explain what the fuck is going on. You can figure it out yourself in the end, and it doesn't. It just okay. Well, there was a whole pile of fucking nothing. So yeah, it's not horrible. It's bad. I mean, it's not horrible. It's bad. Just bad. So yeah, now we're gonna play Butcher Bay. And a lot of people say it's, you know, to be honest, a good game. And well, I hope it's a good game, but this was fucking horrible, to be honest. Okay. Well, Dark Athena. Bad. Okay, Butcher Bay then. Okay, done with Butcher Bay. Well, you can see at the beginning that it was going to be a lot fucking better than Dark Athena. I mean, the beginning was so much fucking better than Dark Athena's. And it never tried to be this dark and etchy bullshit like Dark Athena tried, when which is good because either way it wouldn't really work, to be honest. And well, if you compare it to, I mean, if you strictly compare it to Dark Athena, it's pretty fucking great. And back to hand-to-hand combat, it wasn't me who did it wrong. The thing is that you need to mash, you know, up, down, left, right until they're dead. I mean, it doesn't have any strategy or skill to it. Well, what that means is that it's mindless. Whether that's good or bad, well, that's up to you. For me, it's just meh, it doesn't really fucking matter. And well, the gameplay, it has more variety, kinda. I mean, the game changes to different situations and shit, but you still do the same shit, but in different situations. Like, first you're in the prison, then you fight zombies, then you got them ice thingies, and then you fight, you know, Xenos. So, well, it's a bit better than Dark Athena's combat. I mean, in Dark Athena, it was the same fucking shit in the same fucking situation all the fucking time. I mean, it was minor fucking changes. I mean, in Butcher Bay, it was major fucking changes, but it wasn't really the core gameplay that changed, it was more the situation you were in. The story is a lot better too, compared to Dark Athena. It has a goal and shit, and you can understand what's going on, and they explain a lot. But one thing, there's one fucking thing they don't fucking explain, and that is, well, I'm gonna spoil it. Somewhere when your first attempt of fleeing, you hear this voice, or this female voice, and she talks shit and that, and she gives you the eyes, and well, they never fucking explain what the fuck is going on with that. I mean, she returned a little bit near and then and here and there, and it never really explain what the fuck is going on, to be honest, and they never do. It just ends like it, they never fucking do it. I mean, when you forget it, then it's come back again, and then well, why could you just drop it if you're not gonna fucking explain it? But anyway, and well, another thing compared to Dark Athena. When Dark Athena never really ended, I mean, it's continued, you know, they extended the fucking bullshit. In the Butcher Bay, it was actually pretty great that they extended it because then it led to something new, to be honest. I mean, it was kind of fucking great that you got captured again and then you know, returned to how it was before, but in a different situation. But near the end, it was, you know, they were running out of ideas and it was getting pretty fucking boring, but well, it ended. So, it ended decent. And Riddick doesn't act like a fucking retard anymore. What he says actually makes fucking sense now. So, yeah, that's fucking great. So, yeah, in conclusion, well, I mean, it's only compared to Dark Athena this game's, you know, really fucking science. I mean, it's a great fucking game, but only if you compare it to Dark Athena. I mean, the story is pretty fucking good if you compare it to Dark Athena. The gameplay is pretty fucking good if you compare it to Dark Athena. I But if you're going to, making general in a game in general and today's standards, well, to be honest, it's not that good. It's. I mean, if I'm gonna be fucking nice, I'm gonna say, well, it's good, but it's not. It's decent. I mean, it's mediocre at best. I mean, sometimes it's actually pretty fucking bad. I mean, that it. When they never really explained the fucking woman, but insisted on returning to that fucking point, it was really a bad fucking decision. I mean, it really took down the entire fucking game. It never really showed anything. The characters are good. I mean, compared to Dark Athena, it wasn't a waste of fucking time. I mean, here, I mean, it wasn't so many fucking characters, and the ca character was, easily fucking built. I mean, they didn't need to deploy anything to it, so it wasn't really a fucking waste of time, to be honest. It wasn't really stuck talking to people all the time, learning the character quest. It wouldn't have fucking mattered. They fucking knew it wouldn't fucking matter, so why didn't they fucking think so about Dark Athena? But, well, in conclusion, well, I say, to be honest, it's mediocre, it's decent, it's neither good or bad. If you're gonna be very fucking nice, then well, it's good. Compared to Dark Athena, it's great. So yeah, I say it. Well, it's mediocre. It's decent. It's average.